Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, a retired lecturer in rheumatology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm going to describe the table which my father had drawn in 1947 or so, and which I'm explaining. So I was explaining the sayings of Sadhguru Nanak. That was in the previous video. Hindu Anna, Hindu is similar to Jew, who deal with the moral laws or who worship Adam. Adam is the Brahma and Yahweh, they are the same thing. So in Rabbi, he has a disciple, so are the Pharisee and Sadducee. So these disciples, they do what their guru or the rabbi tells them to do. As in synagogue, you know, the rabbi will tell the people what to do, they will just do it. So they have the disciples. In Christ Jesus, we have the freedom. We are not bound by him. We do it for the love of his word. He created an atmosphere among his laborers that they love to hear of our Father's royal kingdom. So he then uttered parables and other things, and he trained them in the vineyard of our Father. And at Pentecost, he paid them their wage, which was Holy Spirit. So the twice-born people, when first they become alert, mentally they become undermined. When they have overpowered the ego, then they go into the mind. So when they are in the control of the mind or man, then they try to, they are doubting type. They have two choices, to go for either God or go for Mammon. And some people, you know, go for God, while mostly they'll go for Mammon. In India, 99.9% go for Mammon, and only hardly 0.01% go for God. Whereas in the West, you know, they like to go more than 50% for the God and 50% for Mammon. So that's why Christ Jesus said, lightning strike in the East, India, but it doesn't flash there, but flashes towards the West, that the people of the West will appreciate what I am preaching. So Turku is the one, Turk mean the one to abstain, to hate. Not, you know, our mind say, I want to buy this thing, I want to have more land, this and that, but our wisdom say no, is keep, be contented. So that mean the Turku mean who is a greedy person who want to acquire the whole world. So Turku kana mean that he is opportunist. So twice born seeker of his word, laborers. Psychic is an opportunist, while those who are, you know, as sealed to serve God, they are called Gyani. Gyani mean knowledgeable person. Gyani duha te siyana. Duha mean two, te mean out, say off, siyana mean wise person. So the Gyani is wiser than both of the other two. Sealed to serve God, a learned worker is wiser than the two, previous two which you have mentioned. Then fourth stage, you know, this thing doesn't apply. They are the spokesmen of God, called Bhagat in India, above the other three. All in all, like our Father. So they have the very spirit of our Father. So they are wiser than the worldly people. That is what they say. Our wisdom is foolish to the wisdom of our Father. Then the next one, which is also interesting, that punch for one. So punch mean five, for one mean that mean there are sanctions. So the salvation is to the physical body of five tat. Now physical body of five tat, because it's the body that takes birth and death cycle. Not soul is never born, never dies. So when our soul works hard and preaches gospel and become like our Father, then we too become eternal like our Father. We become His seed. Remember John's gospel? That Christ Jesus had made us the sons of the Most High Father God. So that is what, when we get it, then we get salvation. So salvation goes to the physical body, that it won't be coming into that death and birth cycles. Panch Pradhan. Now the panch here is five. Pradhan means they preside, they are the Lord. Five senses of mind. I will deal with those five senses later on. So these five senses, you know, they are always the one which dominate, that they are the one who acquire knowledge for you. If they are not working, then you cannot attain, you cannot gather knowledge, or you cannot get the material that that converts the what you see into knowledge. So we call them Gyat Indre. Gyat mean the one who help you to get the knowledge. Indre mean the parts of the body. So this will be explained later on. So then third one is Panche Pave Dargah Man. So the five action centers, which is Karan Roop, we call it. Karan means that one who puts the thing into action. So they earn Panche Pave Dargah Man. So those five, they, through their deeds, philanthropic deeds, under the wisdom, they are Karmindre. That means those who put the things into action, five. This I will explain which are these fives. So they earn the honor in the court of our Father. So Panche Pave Dargah Man. Dargah means that our Father's court. So the fourth one, fourth Virdhi, they sports and protect those solitary who enter into the royal kingdom of God. So the fourth one, you know, this doesn't apply. So the Bhagat and saints, they are already one with God. They have joined themselves. They have attained that perfection. So they help others to gain that profession. So that's what they are helpful to the other people. They protect the other. So their occupants are participant. In Adam, we have races. Races are our physical body. Then bunch is in India, this word we use. So it's a subdivision of race. Then we have subdivision of bunch is are tribes, and the subdivision of tribes are surnames. Then we have families, and to the individual family it comes, you know. Then in the second communities, six, Christ, and not Christians of the book, you know. Bodhi, the disciples are the one who learned about Buddha. Then we have Muslims who are studying Quran. Quran is an odd book. Our Allah is Sharia free. So, but this has Sharia, you know, which is, that is why it is called odd book in our Holy Bible. Then third community is Khalsa. Khalsa means, Khalas means pure. And Khalsa means the one who is a pure of the all the temptations of this world, of ego. He has overpowered, mind. He has become pure. And that is called Khalsa. That is called movement in Arabic and Puritans in English. Remember, Oliver Cromwell was a Puritan. He did fight, he did win, but he did not want to sit on the throne. So that's what the philanthropy mean. So in Hinduism, they call Devta. That means he's a very nice person, you know. He does not cheat anyone, or he always helpful. Then in the fourth community, we are fellow workers. Fellow workers are Satsangi. Sat mean his word, gospel truth. Sangi mean companions. So apostles, Arif. Apostles and Arif is Arabic word, means same thing as apostles. So they are the people of the fourth spiritual state, and in which they then preach gospel to the people of the second community. Now this is the age when the rabbis and pandits become blind to spirit. Then they cannot teach you anything except moral laws. So they can't tell you anything about the gospel of God. So the gospel of God is always learnt by the people of the second community who are twice born. So then we have their places of worship, F. In India we call them mandirs. And in where they are keeping statues, you know, of their prophets and all that. Because the children can understand the concrete things, because they are not capable of understanding the abstract spiritual thing yet. So the children, who are the main occupant of the mandirs and synagogues, the once born, who are fed on milk, milk is the scriptures. So they learned the moral laws from the rabbi. So then the second one is Sikh temples, which are without any statue. And there are, these days they are having picture, you know, in the on the wall you see them, of Nanak and all that. That you can reflect, you know, that how spiritually dead these people are. Remember that when the Messianic Jews, they occupied the church, and they had killed the apostles, though apostles were coming into their church, and the church member congregation said, "Ah, we want Christ." They could not know Christ in spirit because they were made drunk with the written Torah. So when they were drunk with the old wine, they have no desire for the new wine. So they could not understand the gospel when apostles used to go and preach. They were not fit for that. So these people, you know, who are in these Sikh temples, which are also, you know, just people go there to eat, social life, and the churches, etc., you know, they are the spiritual places where they should learn gospel, and mosques also, you know, for spirituality. Then we have a third community of Khalsas. In India, we have four true thrones. We call them Sache Takht, for the philanthropists, that is for the Khalsas, where Khalsas live. they don't live in their family homes. Because when the Khalsa was organized, they were beheaded in publicly. Then one person's head, the other person's torso was sewn together, and then through nectar they were made alive. So after seeing all these things, then many people took baptism. So when your head is cut, you know, you have no mother, no father, no wife or children to look after, or to, they are your parties, they are your relations, because you have joined a new community where all those spiritual people who have given their heads or become philanthropists, they are your brethren and they are your in God. You represent then the God. Then the fourth one is the wilderness, which is the, we called it Sachkhand, for preaching gospel, and where the Nirmala Sant, you know, they go for it, and they don't take any money, no mammon is put in their pocket. God, our Father, bless you.